A security analyst, meanwhile, advises China to move on from the alleged gentleman's agreement made in the West Philippine Sea during the Duterte administration. Romel Banlawi says the two sides must return to the negotiating table to find a way to move forward in their maritime row. But he says defense and security officials should avoid being very vocal about the issue to prevent tensions from spiraling.
The so-called understanding reached between President Xi Jinping and President Duterte was an understanding between two leaders, but not the commitment of the government. And now we have a new government that doesn't have the same understanding with President Xi Jinping. We need to bring back diplomacy on the table, and I would like to see our defense and security establishments to be quiet on the issue. Just doing their jobs but not talking about it. It's elevating the discourse from mere diplomatic and political problem to a military problem.
Defense and trade high on the agenda when the leaders of the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines meet at the White House next week. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Jose Manuel Romualdez, says aside from those two main points, cooperation in technology, supply chain, resiliency, and energy will also be discussed. When it comes to defense, maritime tensions between the Philippines and China are expected to dominate the talks. Ambassador Romualdez is confident the world is on Manila's side on the issue.
We have continued to try to use maximum restraint in our relationship with China. We have made it clear that we will not give up any of our territories, but we continue to reach out and tell them that we are ready to sit down and talk seriously about how to resolve some of the issues involving the territorial claims. All countries are supporting the Philippines, and almost all countries are supporting us in our arbitral award, and that is what it is. And so we will continue to push along those lines.
The highly anticipated trilateral summit will be held on April 11th. The Philippine Environment Department wants to do away with the services of a foundation that has a contract to preserve the Masungagia Reserve in Rizal Province. Environment Secretary Tony Yulo Loizaga claims the contract with the Masungagia Reserve Foundation was void from the very beginning. Loizaga told a Senate hearing the Justice Department considers the contract unconstitutional and recommended it be canceled. The foundation says the planned cancellation betrays the agency's stance on protecting the environment. It warns the move will only benefit fraudulent claimants, land grabbers, and resort owners. The contract was signed in 2017. It aims to restore nearly 2,700 hectares of degraded forest land in Rizal. Philippine economic managers lower the country's growth targets for this year and the next. The National Economic Development Authority says it expects the country's GDP to settle between 6 to 7% in 2024 and between 6.5 to 7.5% in 2025. This comes after Manila missed its economic growth target last year.
The revised targets for our headline indicators considered the country's recent economic performance in fiscal year 2023 and reflect the latest developments and expectations on external factors such as global demand and trade growth, oil price movements, and expected exchange rate and inflation trends. These growth targets will sustain the country's position as one of the fastest growing emerging economies in the Asia-Pacific region. Moreover, at this pace of growth, we are still on track to achieving or to reducing poverty incidence from 18% in 2021 to single digit level in 2028.
The inflation target for the next 4 years, though, was retained at 2 to 4% even after consumer prices broke a four-month deceleration streak in February. Official inflation numbers for March will be released tomorrow, Friday.